friends, so after covering the two numericals on Green's theorem, let's see the next numerical based on Green's theorem, where we'll be taking a different function and the different curve to evaluate value of that by using Green's theorem. So here we have to evaluate integral e to the power minus x sine y dx plus e to the power negative x cos y dy by using the Green's theorem. And here the curve C is given as a rectangle whose vertices are given. Now guys, to evaluate it by the Green's theorem, let's write down the statement of Green's theorem, and then after drawing the given curve, we can evaluate the integration. So my question is, what is Green's theorem? Okay, so I'm sure that you have watched my previous video, and in that I've covered the Green's theorem, the statement of Green's theorem and the theorem where I've proved it why the left hand side of a single integral is equal to double integral over the region R. So I'll write down that statement for you and then we'll start the numerical. So guys, this is the Green's theorem. Now, if you will see the given integral, then it is in the form of p dx plus q dy. So if I compare this given integral with this left hand side, then I can get the value of p and q. So by Green's theorem, we say that the value of this integral is equal to area of that region where p and q are the functions of x and y. So guys, let's find out p and q. So here I'll say, comparing this integral with the form integral p dx plus q dy. So here we have e to the power minus x sine y dx. So it means this value becomes my p, and this value which is along dy, that will become my q. So now guys, we got the value of p and q. So to find out the value of this integral by using Green's theorem, we have to find out the limits of this double integral, and we have to find out the value of this dou q by dou x and dou p by dou y. So let's find out this value. So to find out dou q by dou x, I'll differentiate this q with respect to x partially, and then I'll differentiate p with respect to y partially, so that I'll get dou p by dou y. So dou p by dou y is, so e to the power minus x is constant, which is as it is, and the derivative of sine y is cos of y. Similarly, if I find dou q by dou x, then cos y is a constant, it will remain as it is, and the derivative of e to the power minus x is e to the power minus x into minus 1. So this is the answer. Now guys, we got these two values. After this, we have to find out the limits of the integral. But to find out the limits of the integral, we have to draw the given region. So here, I'll draw that curve and we'll see the boundaries of the curve, and based on that, we'll decide the limits. So here, that curve is given as the rectangle whose vertices are given. So I'll draw that curve. So first, vertex is 0, 0. So here, this one is the first vertex. Now pi comma 0, so this will come on the x-axis. So let's say this is pi, so this will become b, which is pi comma 0, because y coordinate 0 on x-axis. Next pi comma pi by 2, and next 0 comma pi by 2. So let's say if this is pi, then I can say this is pi by 2, so this will become pi by 2. So here this point can be 0 comma pi upon 2, so I can call it as d, and the c coordinate is pi comma pi by 2. So this one is pi, and this one is pi upon 2, so here I'll get that point. So here I can draw this line. Let's say this is C, which is pi comma pi by 2. So guys, here we got the rectangle. Now what we have to do is, from this rectangle we have to find out the limits of integration. So here you can see that we have a double integral, and whenever we want to integrate the, or whenever we want to find out the limits of the double integral, what we do is we consider a strip. So either we consider a strip parallel to x-axis or with parallel to y-axis. So here guys, I'll take a strip parallel to y-axis. So let's say this is a strip. Now what do? Whenever we take a strip parallel to y-axis, in the integration we first integrate with respect to y. So we'll be saying dy and then dx. So along this I'll be writing the integration. So here this is the value. So I'll say, let's call this value as I. So I'll say I equal to double integral, next dou q by dou x minus dou p by dou y. So this is a dou q by dou x minus this. So if I subtract this value, so that will become minus 2 times e to the power minus x into cos y. Next dy and dx. So I've taken first dy because I'm considering a strip parallel to y-axis. So whenever we take a strip parallel to y-axis, we have to find out the y-coordinates of the strip. So here the y-coordinate of this strip will get 0, because this point lies on x-axis and on the x-axis y 0. Now here y coordinate is pi upon 2, because you can see that on this whole line y coordinate is pi by 2. So here the y coordinate is pi by 2, and this becomes my coordinate for the integration. So y is varying from 0 to pi upon 2. Now let's find out the coordinates for x. So how do we find it out? So in the previous problem I have explained you, but still I will revise it quickly. So what do? Is we take this strip and then we move that strip horizontally over the whole region. So we'll be moving this strip from here to here, because that is our region. And what do? We take the extreme points of that region. So let's say my strip is moving from here to here, then the extreme point will be this and this. So on these extreme points we find out the coordinates of x. So at this extreme point x is equal to 0, at this extreme point x is equal to pi. So guys, it means my strip is gonna move throughout this region from this point to this point. It will never exceed these two points. So these are two extreme points, or the x coordinates of these two extreme points are my limits. So x is varying from 0 to pi. And guys, don't forget that whenever we move this strip, so we have to take the coordinates from left to right. So we write 0 to pi, because few students make the mistake, they write pi to 0. But remember one thing, that values on the x-axis increases as you go to the right hand side. That is why we have to take limit from left to right. Similarly, whenever we take a strip which is upward or parallel to y-axis, that time we take limits from lower end to the upper end. So that is why it is 0 to pi upon 2. Now guys, we'll be evaluating the integration. So here minus 2 is a constant, I can take it outside. So negative 2 outside. Here integral 0 to pi, I'll not touch this. We will just evaluate this function with respect to y. So now e to the power minus x is a constant, we'll keep it as it is. Now why it is constant? Because we are integrating with respect to y. Now what is the integration of cos y, guys? So it's a sine y. So here I'll say it is sine of y, and limit for y is from 0 to pi upon 2, and dx will remain as it is. Now guys, let's put upper and lower limit. So if I put pi by 2, I'll get sine pi by 2 minus, then I'll put 0, so sine 0. So it is negative 2 integral 0 to pi e to the power minus x. Now here sine pi by 2 is 1 minus sine 0 is 0. So it means we are gonna get 1. So 1 into e to the power minus x is e to the power minus x. Now what is integration of e to the power minus x? So here I'll write down. So it is equal to I is equal to minus 2. Integration is negative e to the power minus x from 0 to pi. Now let's put these values, that is upper and lower limit. So minus 2 as it is. If I put, or I'll take negative sign outside, so that will become positive 2. And in this I'll put pi and 0. So I'll get e to the power minus pi, middle sign minus, next e to the power 0 is 1. So it means our answer is 2 times e to the power minus pi minus 1. And guys, this is nothing but the value of the integral. So here we got the value of this integral by using Green's theorem. So I'm sure that you understood how I've evaluated it by using Green's theorem. So keep watching more videos so that you will understand the more concepts of engineering mathematics. Thank you very much.